In this video, we will capture a trench with Pix4Dcatch, a viDoc RTK rover, and an iPad. Then we will upload the images to Pix4Dcloud Advanced so we can work with a model of the project area, which will provide us with a 3D representation of the trench and the service lines. After you mount the viDoc RTK rover to your iPad and turn it on, launch Pix4Dcatch. To acquire RTK measurements, you will need to establish a connection between your viDoc RTK rover and an end-trip service. To do so, enter the end-trip details, including the host name or IP address, port number, username, and password. The information you enter will depend on the end-trip service you work with. Then click Connect. After you have connected to your end-trip service, you must select the mount point from which you will receive your corrections. Then, indicate the coordinate system in which those corrections will be received. If you have questions about which mount point or coordinate system to select, please contact your end-trip service provider for more information. After Pix4Dcatch indicates that you have an RTK fix, you can choose the appropriate settings. More information about Pix4Dcatch settings is available in Pix4D's support documentation. For this project, we will use the default settings. Before we begin, let's get a sense of the area we are going to look at today. As you can see, we have a relatively small trench that turns at a 90-degree angle to the left, with two small pieces of earth-moving equipment on either side. Now that we have seen the site, let's get started. Plan how you are going to move through the project area before you start capturing images. In this case, we attached the iPad to a monopod so we can more easily capture both sides and the base of the trench. After you have identified what you must capture, start capturing your images. In our experience, we have found that smooth transitions generate more accurate and complete reconstructions. Therefore, make sure you do not abruptly change the direction you are pointing the camera. Keep things fluid, slow, and smooth as you walk across your site, and watch both where you are walking and your iPad screen. If you cannot avoid capturing something that moves through the site, or you want to look around to make sure you are on the right track, you can temporarily pause capturing images. You can also pause and then reposition the camera to capture everything that is relevant to your project. Make sure you capture every surface, object, or feature that is relevant to your work, and at the same time, avoid capturing things that are not relevant to your work. Now that we've captured the trench, we'll stop capturing images. Before you upload your photos to Pix4Dcloud Advanced, you can take a quick look at the images to make sure you've captured a complete and clean dataset. You can upload your dataset to Pix4Dcloud Advanced when you have a solid internet connection, either with a SIM card in the iPad, a hotspot with another mobile device, or by connecting to a Wi-Fi network. On iPads that include a LiDAR sensor, choose whether or not you also want to upload the LiDAR data along with the images. You can also select the coordinate system of the 3D model and other outputs that will be generated. Then, upload the dataset from your iPad to Pix4Dcloud Advanced. When you finish uploading the dataset, Pix4Dcloud Advanced will automatically start to generate a 3D model of the trench. After you receive a notification that Pix4Dcloud Advanced has finished processing your dataset, return to Pix4Dcatch on the iPad. Open the dataset with Pix4Dcatch and then open the 3D model of the trench. You can then navigate around the 3D model of the trench and collect a handful of different types of geometric measurements or add line work for each of the service lines. You can also give other people access to the same 3D model so you can all work in the same environment and avoid any misunderstandings. If you cannot get the job done on your iPad, you can access the same 3D model on any computer that is connected to the internet when you log in to Pix4Dcloud Advanced. More information about Pix4Dcatch and Pix4Dcloud Advanced is available in the support documentation at support.pix4d.com.